2004, Captain Chris Ross, U.S. Air Force Academy Class of 2003, and Captain Adrian Martin, Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University Class of 2003. Also joining them today is Loadmaster Tech Sergeant Chris Baker. This highly experienced crew has a combined total of over 12,000 flying hours in various Air Force aircraft. The C-17 made its first flight in September of 1991. Since then, the aircraft has set over 30 world records, including payload to altitude, time to climb, and the longest airdrop mission in history. The new age design includes a modern computerized glass cockpit, heads-up displays at both pilot stations, and an advanced cargo handling system, allowing it to operate with a crew half the size of similar cargo-carrying aircraft. To start off today's demonstration, the crew will perform a high-speed pass. With the aircraft capable of accelerating to over 350 miles per hour, this pass demonstrates the extremely powerful engines of this magnificent jet.
Right here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the C-17 is now approaching from your left. Please notice how quiet it is while passing by show center. This gives the operators a tactical advantage while flying low over hostile territories and allows for more suitable operations at airfields near heavily populated cities. Such as the C-5 Galaxy, with the short field landing potential of the much smaller C-130 Hercules. The C-17 is powered by four Pratt & Whitney F-117 engines. These are the same engines used on the Boeing 757. Each engine delivers over 40,000 pounds of thrust. This amount of thrust allows the Globemaster III to carry over 170,000 pounds of cargo for an astounding range of up to 2,400 nautical miles without even utilizing air-to-air refueling. Now approaching from your right, the aircraft will perform a slow-speed pass. During the pass, please notice the wing leading edge slats and large power lift wing flaps. These devices literally change the shape of the wing and are the key to its low final approach speed, enabling this aircraft to land and stop in very short distances. Ladies and gentlemen, please get your cameras ready, as this will be your best opportunity to take photos of this amazing state-of-the-art machine. Showing its ability to fly at slow speeds and demonstrate its advanced aerodynamics in action. The aircraft uses a quadruple redundant fly-by-wire system for the operation of flight controls. This is combined with four separate flight control computers, each capable of controlling the entire system independently. The system is designed to optimize the capabilities of the C-17, yet maintain enough redundancy to protect against a wide variety of failure conditions. Another feature of this amazing flight control system is that the aircraft can also be flown in an entirely mechanical backup mode, further safeguarding against abnormal situations. Ladies and gentlemen, in case you're wondering how big the C-17 is, the wingspan is roughly 170 feet, the tail is over 5 stories tall, and fully loaded, it weighs over 580,000 pounds. As the aircraft approaches from your left, please notice the upturned wingtips or winglets. These decrease aerodynamic drag and increase fuel economy. Now to give you a better idea of the aircraft's overall size, the winglets are nearly 9 feet tall. First off, this aircraft can fly anywhere in the world non-stop using its air-to-air refueling capability. Air Force personnel routinely fly 24-hour missions with a single crew. The most basic crew complement required to operate a C-17 is merely 2 pilots and 1 loadmaster. The heavy-duty landing gear allows it to land on surfaces such as cement, sand, dirt, and even ice. As a result of this, C-17s have been in over 180 countries and literally every continent in the world since production began. Lastly, all current Air Force crews are trained on the use of night vision goggles or NVGs, allowing them to operate while in unlit, master locations around the globe. This versatile aircraft is used for many types of missions around the world, ranging from emergency medical evacuations and humanitarian relief efforts to frontline combat support. In fact, last year during Operation Tomodachi in Japan, members from this very crew airlifted life-saving humanitarian supplies and support personnel within hours of a devastating tsunami. Timely airlift has allowed recent humanitarian operations in support of flooding in Thailand and Pakistan, destructive earthquakes in New Zealand, Haiti, Chile, and Indonesia, a tsunami in Samoa, delivering aid and supplies to Honduras, the Philippines, Georgia, and many more. Their final approach, the aircraft will be flying at just under 120 miles per hour. They are simulating arrival to a shortened airfield where hostile forces are present. This versatile tactic allows a C-17 to operate at over 6,000 more airfields worldwide than commercial wide-body aircraft. Harbor using just over 1,000 feet of runway. Is currently demonstrating the ability to back under its own power, which gives it increased maneuverability while offloading cargo and the capability to operate at smaller, unsupported airfields. All the maneuvers you have seen here today are examples of those flown by our operational air crews on a regular basis, as they provide the highly responsive and flexible airlift capability for America. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's demonstration. On behalf of the men and women of the United States Air Force, Pacific Air Forces, and Joint Base Pearl Harbor-Hickam, Hawaii, we thank you for being with us today, and we hope you enjoyed this brief look at the C-17 Globemaster III. The United States Air Force's core airlifter and workhorse, which will continue to provide rapid global mobility for America today, tomorrow, and well into the 21st century.
Ladies and gentlemen, Captain Angela Kibler and the C-17 Globemaster III. Remarkable airplane.
I sent you his email, correct?
Airplane even has a tunnel in the tail of it that allows maintenance people to crawl up into the tail and take a look back there, do some inspections. From Honolulu, Hawaii, Hickam Air Force Base, the C-17 Globemaster III. They're anxious to get back to where it's warm and sunny in Hickam, so they're going to load up and leave. Sergeant George Perez from Puerto Rico out there, Georgie, handling the all-important ground controller activities for